Today, I'm going to discuss about a notification of Android using Kotlin. First, we have to see what is meant by notification, and then we'll see implementation of notification of Android using Kotlin. A notification is a message you can display to the user outside of your application's normal UI. You already know the notification. This is the notification which contains icon, title, and description. You can assign here big text also, big image also. And it appears as an icon in the notification area. This is the notification area outside the application. To see the details of the notification, the user opens the notification drawer. When notification appears, we have to drag and open the notification drawer. Both the notification area and the notification drawer are system controlled areas that the user can view at any time. Here system level icons there, and when you drag, it will show the notification symbols. Then if you click on that, then it will open the notification. Here see the more examples of notifications. Any image you can connect with that icon, big text, big icon. And it is a, you know the intent, which is a action taken is the intent. Here outside the application it requires, and it is displayed by the system. Therefore pending intents are used here, because it is the future action. Whenever you click, it will execute outside the application. Then Android notification provides short, timely information about the action happened in the application, even it is not running, because it is from outside the application. And it displays icon, title, and some amount of the context text. You can include here big, set small icon, set content title, set content text, set auto cancel, set priority. So many methods are there. And here without configuring notification channels, you cannot build notification for applications with Android API greater than equal to 26. If API is greater than equal to 26, you can use notification channel mandatory. It is mandatory. If less than 26, the notification builder is required to create a notification. API is greater than equal to 26, then notification channel is mandatory. Each channel is supposed to have a particular behavior which will be applicable to all the notifications which are a part of it. Every channel therefore have a channel ID, which basically act as a unique identifier for this channel, which will be useful if user wants to differentiate a particular notification channel. Every channel have one unique ID, and in that channel you can create your notification. A notification builder provides a convenient way to set the various fields of a notification and generate content views using the platform's notification layout template, but is not able to target a particular notification channel. In notification builder is the convenient way to set the various fields of a notification. here we can see how to create notification using Kotlin. First, we have to create the new project. After creating new project, activity main.xml and main activity.get. Then main.xml code, it will default automatically display text view. Convert that text view to button and Android text is equal to send notification. Android ID for button is a bin underscore button. Layout width, wrap content, layout height, wrap content, center in parent is equal to true. Android color, you can change color also, text color. Here you press, then it will change the color. It can take the color, and if you give OK, then it will change the text color. Here text size is equal to 24 sp. Then main activity dot get to create any notification. So many imports are there. Here import notification, notification channel, notification manager, pending intent, contest intent, bitmap factory, bundle, notification compact, notification manager compact. So many imports are required here. First we have to create, this is the main program which we have to first create notification channel. Then for button, after clicking the button, some event will be happened. Then in that we call send notification. This is the main program, and we have to create three variables: channel ID, notification ID, and description. These three parameters are required to create any channel. Then create notification channel. Private function create notification channel. If build version SDK int greater than equal to 26, then notification channel is required. I already tell that. Val name is equal to notification title, description text, notification description, importance underscore default, notification manager dot importance. We have to set the importance of your notification. Importance default, it beeps the sound. Val channel, notification channel is equal to notification channel, it create notification channel, and we have to pass the parameters: channel ID, name, name comma importance dot apply, dot apply, description is equal to description text, description text, name, channel ID is equal to channel ID example 01, name, notification title, and importance. Description text is equal to notification description. We have to store that text into description variable. It will create a notification channel, and then notification manager controls all the activities. Get system service, contest dot notification service as notification manager. Then notification manager dot create notification channel. And channel is equal, here variable is, variable means object is a channel which have value of notification channel, and it will pass to the create notification channel, and it controls by notification manager. Then send notification, another you have to create a on click listener. Then send notification is another function which send the notification. Here while intent have contest, program name, class name, and apply intent flag activity new task or flag activity clear task. flags is equal to intent dot. Here the tasks are clear or it can assign a new task. Then pending intent. Pending intent, it is the future action because it runs outside the application, therefore it is a pending intent. Get activity, bitmap. If you want to store your some icon, large icon, small icon, here I give two files, bitmap large icon, r dot drawable dot urp mook and r dot drawable dot android mook. You have to copy two files here in drawable folder and take this for bitmap, one for small icon and another for decode resource application context dot resources, and we have to store bitmap is equal to this and bitmap large icon is equal to this. Then again notification val builder, notification builder to build a notification. Notification dot builder contains this channel ID. You have to pass the channel ID here. Set small icon. C dot I launcher foreground. Set content title, example title, context text, example description. Example description. Set large icon, bitmap large icon. Bitmap large icon is equal to this file. Bitmap. Set style notification big. Here, if you want to set large icon, then use this big picture. Set style notification dot big picture style, big picture bitmap. Bitmap is equal to this file. This is the icon. Set content intent, pending intent, and here with notification manager notify notification ID comma builder dot build. Here we have to pass the parameters, that is notification ID, and then builder dot build. It will create a notification. After executing this program, it will show this screen. We have to write relative layout, take a relative layout and button which have send notification. After clicking that, we have to define on click listener for send notification. After clicking that, it will show this. What is the title here? Example title. App name my third notification. Example title set content title. Then example description, that is set content text. Here small icon. It is a large icon. Big picture bitmap and it is a large icon. Two icons are here. Bitmap is equal to and bitmap large icon is equal to. Bitmap large icon have this image. If you want to change that image into text, then only change the this. Dot set style notification dot, here big picture style is required, here big text style dot big text. You have to give here text to display. Then after execution, it will display. It will display. After clicking that, here I already give welcome to notification, welcome to notification 3 times, then example title, and here text is displayed. Here you can assign big text also, any line number, any number of lines. Here you can insert. And this is the small icon. Here you can replace that bitmap image. I hope you all are understood. It is notification. I'm tried my level best how to implement notification with Kotlin. Kotlin is a new language. If you understood concept, then you can easily understood all the implementation. No need to remember any code. You have to. It is an autocomplete feature. If you start line or variable or class, then it will autocomplete all the syntax provided by the Android Studio. Here main thing is notification channel, notification manager and notification builder. And you can set as per your requirement, you can set the design for your notification. And pending intent is a future action. Which is executed outside the application, therefore it is called pending intent. Here pending intent, it is a wrapper around regular intent that is designed to be used by another application. Regular intent is, it is for activity and by system service, and using notification manager, pending intents are launched. It gives other applications the ability to perform the included action as it was your application with all the permissions your application has been granted. It is run by another application with permission of local application. It is a pending intent. Here importance level, importance default, it is used in our program. In notification manager dot importance, we have to define importance levels. Importance high makes a sound and appears as a heads up notification. Importance default makes a sound. Importance low, no sound. And importance mean, no sound and doesn't appear in the status bar. 4 types of importance levels are there. Thank you.